I am Santosh Gadankar. Today I am solving the problems on simply supported beam. This is a simply supported beam having a point loads, and there are the two reactions here. These are the two reaction unknown, RA and RB is unknown. Now the downward force I will consider as a positive and upward I will consider as a negative. Smiling face, sagging, I will consider as a positive. Hogging, I will consider as a negative. Now here we have to find out the reactions here, RA and RB. Therefore I will go for summation of vertical forces is equal to 0. Now this one is nothing but minus RA, as per the condition minus RA, plus 2 plus 5 plus 4 minus RB is equal to 0. Minus RA minus RB is equal to, this entire term has to be brought this side, minus 9 plus 11, 11 minus RA plus, take minus ka outside, RB minus 11, minus minus get cancelled and this vehicle becomes RA plus RB is equal to 11, equation 1, equation 1. Now we have to take the moment about A. I am taking the moment about A. That means this end is fixed now. This end is fixed. As a result, now RB is there. The RB is moving upward in this direction. That means it will sag. It will sag. Therefore, I have to consider positive sign, that is RB into distance, total distance. The total distance will be 1.5, total distance will be 1.5 plus 1.5 plus 1.5 plus 1.5. Now it is moving in this direction. Therefore, we call it a sagging, smiling face, positive. Now here, hogging face, bottom, it moves clockwise. If you consider the anti-clockwise positive, clockwise you can consider as a negative. Minus 4 into distance, that is 1.5 plus 1.5 plus 1.5. Next, minus 5, minus 5 into this distance, into 1.5 plus 1.5. Next, minus 2 into 1.5 is equal to 0, is equal to 0. Therefore RB is equal to 6, and the bring the entire term this side, it will be 4 into 4.5 plus 5 into 3 plus 2 into 1.5. RB is equal to 36 divided by 6, you will get 6 kilonewton. This is 2. Put 2 in 1, sorry, put 1 in 2, you have to substitute this value in here, in equation 1, and becomes RA plus 6 is equal to 11. Further it becomes RA, 11 minus 6 is nothing but 5 kilonewton. Therefore RA will be 5 kilonewton and RB will be 6 kilonewton. We have found the reactions. Now we have to solve the shear force diagram. Shear force diagram or shear force. Now there is a load from the bottom. Therefore you have to consider left and right. SF at B, right side. Right side. Now right side it will be 0. Now left side, SFB, left side. The reaction is, as per your direction, it should be minus. I will consider minus 6 because the bottom arrow is there, minus 6 kilonewton, minus 6. Now I will go for E. There is a point load acting, therefore left hand, so right and left. SFB, SFE, right. That is the previous value we have tried. SFE, left minus 6 plus 4 minus 2. Next at D, again left and right. SF at D, right. Right. That is previous value. Previous value. And there is previous value will be minus 2. Because minus 6 plus 4 is nothing but minus 2. SF at D, left. Left will be here. Left is here. That is minus 2 plus 5. Is nothing but 3 kilonewton. 3. Again, SFC at right. The previous number. 3. Previous number. 3. Now, SFC left. Left is here. Left. This is the left. 3 plus 2. 5 kilonewton. Now at the A, again there is a load. At A there is a load from the bottom. At the A there is a load from the bottom. Therefore, left and right. Now I will consider as the right first. SF A right. Right is nothing but previous number you have to raise as it is. Now from the left, SF A left. Previous value is 5. The bottom value will be minus because number bottom arrow we consider as a negative. Therefore, 0. Draw the shear force diagram. I'm drawing the shear force diagram. The first, this is SFD. Above is positive, bottom is negative. Now, first is 0. This is first is 0. Next is 5. At the A, there are 2 points, 0 and 5. At the C, there are 2 points, 5 and 3. 5 and 3. At D, again, 3 and minus 2. 3 minus 2. At E, minus 2 minus 6. Minus 2 minus 6. At B, minus 6 and 0. Now, complete the diagram. There is no UDL, therefore straight line. Bottom, straight line. There is no UDL here. Bottom, straight line. Straight line. Complete out. Negative, negative, positive, positive. We have completed the shear force. We are going for the bending moment. Bending moment, I will consider here. First, I will consider the bending moment about A. Always the if there is a reactions are there on this side, it will be 0. I will calculate the value. Bending moment. Bending moment at A. Now, as the sagging will be, if you moves anti-clockwise, it will be positive. 6 into total distance. 6 into total distance is nothing but 1.5 plus 1.5 plus 1.5 plus 1.5. Next, 4. Now it is clockwise. Clockwise is nothing but minus 4 into distance. That is 1.5 plus 1.5 plus 1.5. Similarly, minus 5 into 1.5 plus 1.5. Next, minus 2 into 1.5. If you calculate, the value will be 0. If you calculate, the value will be 0. If you calculate, the value will be 0 here. Similarly, we will go for bending moment at C. Bending moment at C, again, anti-clockwise, positive, 6 into distance, 1.5 plus 1.5 plus 1.5 up to here. Now bending moment up to here, this point. Next, minus 4 into 1.5 plus 1.5, minus 5 into 1.5. Calculate, value will be 7.5 kilonewton meter. Next, at D, BM at D. 6 bottom anticlockwise positive, the positive 6 into distance, that is 1.5 plus 1.5. Next, minus 4 into 1.5. Answer is 12 kilonewton meter at E. BM at E 6 into 1.5, 9 kilonewton meter, and bending moment at B will be 0. Now I am drawing the bending moment. Everything is positive here, therefore above is positive and below will be negative. BMD first is 0, next C will be 7.5 kilonewton meter, second is 12 kilonewton meter, D will be 12, and E will be 9 kilonewton meter and 0. Therefore straight line, because there is no UDL. If it is UDL, then you have to go for parabola. Positive. In this way, you have to solve the problem when simply supported beam is provided with the reactions at a point load. I am Santosh Gaidankar. Thank you very much.